apply brake pressure. SRT gang, today I'm going to do a little how-to video on how to install a radar detector with a blend mount and wire tap in your Durango or your Hellcat. Pretty much the same process for most of our cars, the Charger, the Challenger, the Trackhawk. They do have slightly different mounts, which you can order from blend mount specific to your vehicle. So you can get a nice clean setup for your radar detector with no mess and super easy to do. So here we have a brand new Escort Max 360. It normally comes with their smart cord here that plugs into the cigarette lighter and the mount, which on this one, they changed to using a magnet that holds that onto there and then the suction cup. So what we're gonna do is use this kit from Blend Mount. In this case, for the Durango, I used item BMG-2001R as well as a wiretap kit, which this one I happened to get off Amazon because it was cheap and I knew what kind of connections I needed on it. So if you need that information, here's the information from Amazon. So this blend mount kit for the Max 360C, you actually have to take this little block off from the stock suction cup with just the little bolt out here with the thumb screw. This piece gets moved over to the new radar mount here, and that obviously sticks on here magnetically. So this is going to go on here and this is going to mount to the car, and then we're going to tap in to the power wires in the mirror for the power supply to power this, so we don't have to use this cord. And that's what this is for. It uses this little short cable here that plugs in, which you can get this in different lengths. So this will plug into the side of the radar detector, and then we'll use these and these little taps here to go into the connector in the rear view mirror to power this. Then all we have is a short little cord here, and this mounts directly to the mirror mount, so you have a nice clean setup. So what I have here is a meter to check the voltage on the pin so I can find out which one is the hot lead. You could probably look that information up online, but I found it to be sometimes inaccurate. Then I also have a couple little pry tools here, because what we have to do is get this plastic cover off so we can access the connector that's behind here. As you can see, there's a small little wiring harness that comes from underneath the headliner and goes down into here, and that's what powers the buttons and such on the mirror. Pretty simple. You take this section off first and then you can get this off. So I'm going to try with this plastic pry tool, which may not do the trick. Oh, this one popped off easy. So there you go. Didn't even need the pry tool. If you need to see the inside of it, here's what the inside of it looks like. Sometimes you have to pry them off with a pry tool. Now that that piece is off, we need to take this off, which also just pops straight down. And then now you can see our connector right here that we're going to tap into. My guess is obviously going to be that one of the colored ones is the power lead, but what we don't want is a power that's on all the time. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this pin, and there's three wires in this specific one. One's going to be a ground, and then probably one's a power, and one may be a power for something else. It may not be. So chances are it's going to be one of the colored wires. So I'm going to stick this in the back of the connector here where the wire goes in, and then I'm going to check it with the ignition off to make sure that there's no power going to it when the car is off, because we don't want the radar detector to stay on all the time. All right, so I got a ground, what I believe is the ground, and the black one here obviously. And now I turn the ignition on and I'm going to check voltage on this pink wire, And with the ignition on, I have 12 volts. Now, when I turn the ignition off, I want no volts coming to it because we don't want the radar detector to stay on when the car is off. So now with the ignition off, I got no volts. So I know these two wires are the ones that I want to use. So we want to push the pins into the back of the connector so they're nice and tight. See, that one's a little loose. So let me redo this one here. Make sure we get it to stay in there good because we don't want this to come undone. So I got both of those in there. And so just to double check, what we're going to do is we're going to plug these connectors in like such. Make sure the radar detector does not come on, which it did not. Now we're going to turn the car on. And the radar detector is on. So, and then turn the ignition off. And when I open the door, it should turn off. So now we know we got the right wires. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take some of this tape. And the first thing I'm going to do is tape up these two points right here so they don't come undone. And then next, I'm going to tape them over here so that they don't come undone out of the back of the connector. This one is not staying in very well. And tape this bad boy on here. Make sure you use good tape so that the sun and heat doesn't melt it. And one more time, now that we taped it up and moved the wires around, we're just gonna stick this on again and make sure it comes on. It does, so we're good. All right, now that we got all that in place, we're gonna take and just take this guy right here and it's just gonna push right back up into place. Careful you don't pull your wires out. That clips into place. Again, just to be safe, I'm gonna check that my wires didn't come undone. They didn't. So we're gonna route this over top where this other piece goes right here. So we're gonna take this piece and route this over top behind it here, and then we can come down and pop out the side here. We took this magnetic piece off the cup that comes with the radar detector. So now what we're going to do is we're going to mount that to this, the bottom of the mount here. Again, your mount might be slightly different for your radar detector. If you have a different radar detector, the mount ends are different. So we're going to put the two bolts in here. We're not going to tighten it up all the way yet because we're going to want to be able to position it. So what you should have is something like this. Now we're going to take this and mount this to the stem of the rear view mirror. We're going to take this bolt out of the top, set it aside, and we're going to loosen the two lower bolts right here for this part of the bracket so we can spread this out to get it around the stem. And then we're going to take the one for the top and start it in there. Start tightening it down. I know in my particular case, I want this mount ring pressed as far forward as I can. So I'm going to start to tighten this up while making sure I have this pressed forward. And then we're going to start tightening down the sides. Tighten down the sides completely first before you tighten the top one all the way. And we also want to make sure that we're keeping it pretty level. Level this way and pushing it as far forward as we can. And now that those are tight, I can tighten the top one the rest of the way. And now we have this lower portion here, which will stick onto here. And then we can position this swing arm kind of wherever we need it to go to make us happy with the placement. And then we're going to tighten these guys. Plug it in, and we are good to go. So as you can see, we have a nice clean mount here on the stem with no wire hanging down the dash to plug into the cigarette lighter. Nothing stuck to the window. Everything's nice and clean and tidy and sturdy. And we got a nice clean install here. As always, super easy. Hope that was helpful for you guys, for anybody that might be wanting to install a radar detector on their Durango or their Hellcat. Like I said, very similar process for all the Hellcats, Chargers, Challengers, whatever. Just order the blend mount by looking up your car on their website to get the right part number and match to the radar detector that you have. But tapping in with the wiretap kit is super easy. Literally anybody can do it, so y'all get at it.